My name is Chris Bramlett, and today I'm going to share a brief history of the Stanley County YMCA. Originally, the site where the Y is located at the corner of North First Street and C.B. Crook Drive was the location of the Wiscasset School Building. The school had been built about 1912 to serve students from families who worked for both Eford Manufacturing and Wiscasset Mills. The school building played an important part in the lives of the community for the next 30 years. Unfortunately, in April of 1942, the building was destroyed in a fire. It was hoped it could be replaced, but due to construction materials being needed for World War II, nothing was done. During the mid to late 1940s, executives of Wiscasset and the city of Albemarle began conversations about the need for a community center in town. Plans began to be formalized for a YMCA. The location of the Wiscasset School Building was seen as ideal, and construction finally began on November 26, 1949. The Wiscasset Memorial YMCA was officially organized on December 15th of that year when the 45 charter members of the Board of Directors met to formalize plans. After the new building was completed, a dedication ceremony and official opening were held during mid-July of 1950. A membership drive soon led to over 1,000 members, and the hope was there would be many more by the end of the campaign. Wiscasset Mills provided most of the support for the Y over the following decades. In 1984, the Cannon family that owned Wiscasset sold the mill. The new owner decided to give the building and property to the YMCA. The YMCA decided to hold their first capital campaign under the direction of local businessman C.B. Crook. That campaign raised enough money to renovate and expand the facilities. Later on, C.B. Crook led a second campaign and raised even more money to allow the Y to expand again into the wonderful facility that we all can enjoy today. Local businessman Tom Keen was a major factor in both campaigns. During the time the Y has been open, we've had five directors: Ed Holbert, H.C. Cook Jr., John Sturgeon, John Louder, and the current director, George Crooker. They have done a wonderful job managing this facility that is important to the health and well-being of our community.